the most marvelous month to take a Mediterranean cruise. It's warm enough to indulge in gelato in Italy, but still about a month away from the high season, so you can get a 2-for-1 cruise deal. For example, you can take a cruise departing from Genoa, where you may visit the World Heritage Site, where there are 42 palaces, including a red palace that looks a little brownish, and a white palace with the color tones of cream and butter. What's most amazing in the historical district is the Hall of Mirrors at the Royal Palace. There's also a nice antique garden. It's very pleasant to walk around here and then take a side street decorated with colorful umbrellas to a good restaurant. Did you know pesto sauce originated in Genoa? Another tasty specialty here is guanciale sauce. You can easily find gourmet pasta in other Italian cities too. When your cruise takes you to Rome, you can have lunch near the Trevi Fountain. This restaurant's fresh peony flowers are just as appealing as the pasta. May flowers adorn many balconies in Italy. These buildings are in Sicily, the largest Mediterranean island. Besides historical sites, you must visit a Sicilian market, where you can sample a wide variety of cheese and the most special pesto sauce, made of pistachios instead of pine nuts. Speaking of food, you must try a fried rice ball in Sicily. Nowhere else can you get such flavorful rice balls or such fresh octopus marinated with fragrant herbs. Seafood is sensational in Spain as well. When you arrive on the Spanish island of Mallorca, find a local seafood restaurant for lunch. In Mallorca, Palma Cathedral, also known as La Seu, is a must-see. It has one of the largest rose windows in the whole world. Look at all these colorful windows around the interior of the cathedral. Aren't they taking your breath away? Next to the cathedral is a spectacular summer palace of the Spanish royal family. You can pay a small admission fee to go inside to certain areas. This is the king's office. There is a church in the palace, despite its proximity to Palma Cathedral. The seafront location gives the palace a fantastic view. Our next stop is Valencia, the third largest city of Spain. Did you know paella was invented in Valencia? Definitely plan for lunch at the local restaurant for authentic paella. This restaurant is across from Valencia Central Market, one of the largest open-air marketplaces in Europe, where you will see some exotic products like honeycomb, which tastes bland but contains antioxidants. It can replace fruit jam for breakfast. Another must-try in Valencia is horchata, also known as tiger nut milk. Tiger nuts are actually not nuts, but tubers of a certain type of weed. Tiger nut milk tastes sweet, but is sugar-free and high in calcium. It goes particularly well with a pastry called Fartan's Polo. After your market tour, you may not have enough time to stand in line for the renowned Oceanarium, but you can go to the city's largest park, 9 kilometers long, because it used to be a riverbed before the river was diverted. One of the bridges spanning over the park features a beautiful flower ridge on each side. The flowers are in full bloom in May. The park has a gigantic statue of Gulliver, which serves as a playground for children who thrive at acting like Lilliputians. In terms of literature, Marseille is where the fascinating French novel The Count of Monte Cristo begins. At the romantic old port of Marseille, it's easy to envision Edmond Dantès' eyes lighting up with excitement about sailing into port, about returning home to his father and fiancée. There's something spellbinding about the old port that makes even a foreign traveler desire to call it home. Before leaving, you may be tempted to try some of the world-famous bouillabaisse, which comes as a two-course meal. First, you will have fish soup, bread, and saffron butter. The second course is a mixed variety of fish. You may find it overpriced and overrated. However, it's an experience you probably won't want to miss in Marseille. The only downside of taking a cruise is that you get very limited time at each port of call. A week flies by and you are not ready to disembark. How about another Mediterranean cruise departing from Venice next May?